If I were a rich man, I have a dibby-dibby-dibby-dibby-dibby-dum. All day long I bidi-bidi-bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. I have a dibby-dibby-dibby-dibby-dibby-dibby-dum. If I were a bidi-bidi-rich, idle-diddle-diddle-diddle-man.
Thank you. Tradition.
Must know the way to make
Now who can that be?
Michelle, Shoemaker's daughter.
Michelle? She can hardly see. She's practically blind.
Tell them, Shoemaker, if your son's so much to look at, with the way she sees and the way he looks, it's a perfect match.
And now the beggar. I had a bad week.
You had a bad week, my child.
And of course, our beloved rabbi. Rabbi, may I ask you a question?
Of course, my son. Is there a proper blessing for the czar?
A proper blessing for the czar? May God bless and keep the czar far away from us.
Every day of the week, it's once in a lifetime news. Now, where are your daughters?
is better than no husband. God forbid! And who should know better than me? Ever since my husband died, I've been a poor widow, alone. Nobody to talk to. Nothing to say to anyone. It's no fun. All I know when I just think of him, and even thinking of him gives me no pleasure. Because you know as well as I, he was not much of a man. Never made a living. Everything he touched turned to mud. But better than nothing.
Good evening. Is
Zygel
in the house?
But she's busy. You can come back later.
Oh, my God, I thought I heard you.
Finish what you were doing. I said later.
All right.
What is that poor little model? What with Zygel?
They've been friends since they were babies together. They talk. They play.
They play? What do they play?
Who knows? They're just children.
From such children come other children.
Mumble, he's a nothing. Yet you said.
Ah, children, children. They're a blessing in your old age.
But my Aaron couldn't give me children.
Believe me, he was a good man. Never raised his voice. A good man, a fine man. But what good is it if he never raised his voice? What thieves in the plane? Other women enjoy the plane, but not Yenta. Not every woman in the world can be a Yenta. I must prepare my forward at the table, so goodbye, Goda. It was a pleasure talking our heart outs to each other.
Yenta. Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Oh, of course it is. I'm losing my head. One less. It'll fall off on the other. And the poor kick it into the mud. And goodbye, Yenta! Ah, the noose! It's about Mason, the butcher. Believe me, he's a good man. And I don't have to tell you that he's well off. But he's lonely, the poor man. You understand, of course you. To make it short, out of the whole town, he's cast his eye on Zyto.
My Zygel?
No, the Tsar Zygel. Of course, your Zygel.
Such a match for my Zygel. But Tevye wants to learn his man. He doesn't like laser.
Listen to me, Golda. Send Tevye to him, and don't tell him what it's about. Let laser discuss it himself. So win him over, shoot, shoot. So you'll come and help when, and you don't have to bet me, Goda. Because aside from my fee, which anyway Laser will pay, it gives me great satisfaction to make people happy. What better satisfaction is there? So, goodbye, Goda. And you're welcome.
What did she want, Mama? When I want you to know, I'll tell you. Finish washing the floor.
I wonder if Yenta found a husband for you.
They're not anxious for Yenta to have me a husband.
Not unless it's Model, the tailor.
I didn't ask you.
Zygel, you're the oldest. They have to make a match for you.
Or they can make one for me.
They have to prepare one for me. So what do you have to bring?
Oh, Yenta, Yenta.
Somebody has to arrange matches.
Yep.
You are.
We only have one rabbi, and we only have one son. Why shouldn't I want the best?
Well, because you're a girl from a poor family. So whatever answer brings you, take, right? Of course, right.
Right in the middle of the town, a going home, and one even longer coming down, and one more leaving nowhere just for show. I fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can.
Authorities begin this rapture. Lose the bacon.
Amen.
Why do you curse them? What good does your cursing do? You stand around and curse and chatter and don't do anything. You'll all chatter your way into the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
And where are you from?
Kiev. I was a student at the university there.
Uh-huh. The university? Is that where you learned to criticize your numbers?
That's where I learned that there's more to life than talk. You should know what's going on in the outside world.
The outside world? Why should I break my head about the outside world? Let them break their own heads.
He's right, as the good book says. You spit in the air and land on your face. It's nonsense. You can't just close your eyes to what's happening in the world.
He's right.
So, he's right. And he's right.
How can they both be right?
You know, you are also right.
He's right. He's still wet behind the ears. What's that, Deco?
Tell me, the rabbi's order. My cheese.
Ah, so you're from Kiev, merchant. As Abraham put it, I'm a stranger in a strange land.
Moses said that.
Forgive me, as King David put it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses.
For a man slow of tongue, he sure to talk a lot.
And the cheese.
Yeah.
Here, have a piece.
I have no money, but I'm not a beggar. It's a blessing, it's a gift.
Very well, for your sake.
You know, it's no crime to be poor.
In this world, it's the rich who are the criminals. Someday their wealth will be ours.
That would be nice. If they would agree,
I would agree.
And who will make this miracle come to pass?
People. Ordinary people.
Like you.
Like me?
That's nonsense.
Now until your golden day comes for a purchase, how will you live?
By giving lessons to children. Do you have children?
I have 5 daughters.
5?
Daughters!
Girls should learn too. Girls are people.
A random one!
You can open their minds to great thoughts.
What great thoughts?
Well, the Bible has many lessons for our times.
I am a very poor man. Food for lessons? Why don't you stay with us this Sabbath? Of course, we don't eat like kings, but we don't starve either. As the good book says, when a poor man eats a chicken, one of them is sick.
Where does the book say that?
I don't know, but somewhere it says something about a chicken. Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath, children.
Good Sabbath, Papa.
Perfect. This is my oldest daughter.
Good Sabbath.
A very pleasant daughter. I have 5 very pleasant daughters. This is my mwah. This is my mwah. This is my mwah. This is my mwah. This is not mine. This is not what comes oil.
So you did me a favor, take it.
This is also mine. This is Karchik. He is a teacher. Children, how would you like to take lessons from him?
I am a really good teacher. Very good teacher.
I once heard the rabbi who must praise himself has a congregation of 1.
Your daughter has a quick and witty tongue.
The wit she gets from me, as the good book says.
The good book can wait. Get washed.
The tongue she gets from her mother.
Mom, you're also waiting with us?
Yes, my man.
Of course, another blessing. Zeitel, 2 more. Sprint to Belkin. Get washed. Mine can help me.
Tava, Susan, Tommy, the whip boy. You can get washed outside as well. Tevye, I have something to say to you.
Why should today be any different?
Tevye, I have to tell you.
Shh, I'm praying.
Laserwolf wants to see you.
A butcher? About what?
I don't know. Only that he says it's important.
What could be important? I have nothing for him to slaughter.
After the Sabbath, see him and talk to him.
Talk to him about what? He's thinking about buying my new milk cow. He can forget it.
Tevye, don't be an ox. A man sending him sends an important message. The least you can do is talk to him.
Fine. After the Sabbath, I'll go and talk to him.
Are you getting ready for a party?
A party?
A
maybe even a wedding.
A wedding? Wonderful. I'll be happy to make the wedding, Larry. Do the dancing and so forth. For a little fee, naturally.
Naturally, a wedding is no wedding without you and your fee.
Good evening, innkeeper.
Good evening.
We'd like a drink. Join us, can't you?
Vodka? Schnapps?
Vodka.
Right away.
Good evening.
Good evening, gentlemen.
What are you doing here so early?
He wants to buy my new milk cow.
Oh, it's heavy. I'll sit down. Have a drink.
I won't insult you by saying no.
So, how goes it?
Yep. Now shut it go.
You're right.
And you?
The same.
I'm sorry to hear that.
So, how's your brother-in-law? In America?
I suppose doing very well.
You write to
him? Not recently.
Well, how would you know?
If he was doing bad, he would write.
So, I suppose you know why I called you here, Tavia?
Yes, and there's no use in talking about it.
Why not?
Why should I get rid of her?
Well, you would have to do more without her.
Oh, I see. Today you want one, tomorrow you want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
The same you would do with one.
Tavia, this is very important to me.
Important? Why is it so important to you?
Frankly, I'm lonesome.
Wait, what are you talking about?
You don't know?
You're talking about my milk cow, the one you want to buy from me?
A milk cow? So I won't be lonesome? I'm talking about your daughter, Cycles.
My daughter, Cycles.
Of course your daughter, Cycles. She's made a great impression on me, Tanya. I like her. You see, she comes to my butcher shop every Thursday. I mean, you won't need a dowry for her. And besides, you won't need to put anything in your purse either.
And what do you mean, my purse? My size is not the kind that we sell for money.
Fine. You don't want to talk about money then. But, Tavia, I like her. What do you think?
What do I think? I never liked it. Why should I? You could have a perfectly fine conversation with him if you're talking about kidneys or livers. On the other hand, not everybody has to be a scholar. If you're rich enough, no one will call you stupid. But he has a problem. She's much younger than he is. And that's her problem. But she's much younger than he is. That's his problem. I always thought of him as much of us. He is a good man and he will try to make her happy. What do I think? It's a match.
You agree?
I agree.
Oh, Tavia, that's wonderful! Let's drink on it!
To you. No, to you. To the both of us.
For agreement.
For agreement. For our prosperity. For our good health and happiness. And most important,
Cycle!
Mazel tov!
Razor bolt in death!
I'm giving you this news because I like you. You are a decent, honest person. even though you are a Jewish dog.
Thank you, Your Honor. How often does a man touch a compliment like that?
You ever seen orders that sometimes when in this district there should be a little unofficial demonstration?
Talking? Yep.
No, 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 just a little unofficial demonstration.
How little?
Not too serious, just a mission. That as an inspector comes through, he can see that we have done our duty.
And if,
personally, I don't see why they're asking this trouble between people, but I thought I should tell you, and you can tell the others.
Thank you, Your Honor. You are a decent man, if I say so. It's too bad you're not a Jew.
Okay, that's what I like about you. Always joking. Well, congratulations again. You go.
Dear God, you have to send me news like that. On today, all days. It's true, we are your chosen people. But once in a while, match it with someone else. Anyway, thank you for sending a match to my daughter, Saito. Bakaya!
Today we're going to learn about the story of Laban and Jacob from the Bible, and then we'll discuss it together. Alright? Good. Now, Laban had two daughters, Leah and the beautiful Rachel. And Jacob loved the younger Rachel. He asked Laban for her hand in marriage, and Laban agreed. Jacob would work for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
He was an employer. Now, after 7 years, do you know what happened? Laban fooled Jacob. He gave him his ugly daughter, Leah. So to marry Rachel, Jacob was forced to work another 7 years. Now, children, the Bible clearly teaches us you must never trust an employer. Do you understand?
Yes, Richard. Yes, Richard.
Good. Now, the next story we're going to be going through.
Mama, is it up yet?
No, Mama.
Then enough with the lessons. We have to do Papa's work today. He came home and fell in bed last night like a dead man.
I couldn't get a word out of
him. Come on, let's go clean the barn. Call me when Papa gets up.
That was a very interesting lesson, Bridget.
Do you really think so?
Although, I'm not quite sure the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
Neither, I suppose, with the rabbi's son.
My sisters have big tongues.
And what do you know about him? Other than that he's the rabbi's son. Would you be interested in him if he were the shoemaker's son? Or the tinsmith's son?
At least I know he doesn't have any crazy ideas about turning the world upside down.
Of course, any new idea would be crazy to you. Remember, the Lord said, let there be light.
Yes, but he wasn't talking to you, personally.
You have spirit, even a little intelligence. Perhaps.
Thank you.
Well, what good is your brain? Without curiosity, it's a rusty tool. Good day, Huddle.
We have an old custom here. A boy acts respectfully to a girl. I guess it is far too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Our traditions, nothing must change. Everything is perfect just the way it is.
We like our ways.
Our ways are changing everywhere in here. Here, men and women must keep apart. Men study, women in the kitchen. Boys and girls must not touch. Not even look at each other.
I am looking at you.
You're very brave. You know that in the city, boys and girls can be affectionate without permission of the matchmaker? They hold hands together. They even dance together. New dances, like this.
Thank you. I mean, good day.
Good day.
Papa!
No cash, Princess.
think we made a good beginning.
That's good. How do they seem to be doing?
I feel like they're really opening their minds, just as I thought. Exactly the way I wanted to be. You know?
Up! He's finally up! What happened last night besides your drinking like a peasant? Did you see Lazy Wolf?
Well,
what did he say? What did you say?
Well, yes,
do you have to?
I said yes. Patience, woman. Patience. As the good book says, good news will stay. Bad news will refuse to leave. And then there's another saying that goes.
You can die from such a man.
Zytel, there you are. You are to be congratulated. You are going to be married.
Married!
Please, I won't ask for your hand.
The butcher?
What did he say?
What can she say? My firstborn of love? May you grow old with him in honor and fortune. Not like that first wife is, Bruma Sarah. She was a bitter woman. May she rest in peace, not like my Zytel. My first wife, a bride. And now I must confess that. Mazel tov, Zytel.
You call that the mazel tov? Perfect. Aren't you going to congratulate her?
Congratulations, Zytel, for getting a rich man.
Again with the rich. What's so wrong with being rich?
No reason to marry. Money's the world's curse.
May the Lord smite me with it, and may I never recover. My psycho knows I only need her welfare, am I right, psycho? What's wrong? Why are you so silent? Aren't you happy with this blessing?
I can't do it, Papa. I can't marry him. I don't want to.
What do you mean you can't? If I say you will, then you will.
Papa, if it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll hire myself out as a servant. I'll dig ditches. I'll haul rocks. Only please, please don't make me marry him.
What's wrong with Blazer? He is a good man.
I'll be unhappy with him. All my life will be unhappy.
But we made an agreement. And with us, an agreement is an agreement.
Is that more important than I am, Papa?
All right, fine. I won't force you to marry him.
Oh, thank you, Papa.
It seems it's not ordained that you should have all that happiness in life, and that your mother and I should see a little bit of joy in our own age.
Come here, may I speak to you?
Not now, Mabel, go away.
Come here, I need to speak to you.
Not now, I have problems.
That's what I need to talk to you about. I think I can help.
Yes, like a bandage, you can help a corpse. Go away.
At least listen to him, Papa.
You have a tongue? Tongue.
I hear you're arranging a match for Zytel.
He also has ears.
I have a match for Zytel.
What kind of a match?
A perfect fit.
A perfect fit.
Like a glove.
Like a glove.
This man should be exactly to measure.
Made to measure. Like a glove. Stop talking like a tailor and tell me who it is.
Please don't shout the direct of you. Who is it?
Who is it?
Who is it?
Who is it?
It's me. Myself.
And? Himself? You? Yourself? You're completely crazy, or you're out of your mind. You must be crazy!
Please don't shout at me, Rectavia. As for being my own matchmaker, I know it's a little unusual.
Unusual? It's crazy!
Times are changing, Rectavia. The thing is, your daughters, Ivo and I, gave each other a pledge more than a year ago that we would marry.
Gave each other a pledge?
Yes, Papa. We gave each other a pledge.
They gave each other a pledge on a they gave each other a pledge. Impossible! Where do they think they are? In Moscow? In Paris? Where do they think they are? America? And what do you think you're doing, you sitter? You know that! Who do you think you are?
Keep silent!
That isn't the way it's done. Not here, not now. Some things I will not, I cannot allow. Tradition. Marriages must be arranged by the papa. They should never be changed. One little time I pull out a prop. And where does it stop? Where does it stop? Where does it stop? If I have anything to say about my doctrine anymore, doesn't anybody have to ask the father?
I wanted to ask you for some time, Rebecca. First, I want to save up my own sewing machine.
Stop talking nonsense! You're just a poor tail!
And that's true, Rectavia! But even a poor tail can come with some happiness. I promise you, Rectavia, your daughter will not starve.
He's beginning to think like a man. On the other hand, what kind of a man would that be with a poor tailor? On the other hand, he's an honest, hard worker. On the other hand, he is absolutely nothing! On the other hand, things not get worse for him. Only better. They gave each other a pledge, unheard of, absurd. They gave each other a pledge,
impossible.
But look at my daughter's face. She loves him, she wants him. My daughter's eyes, so cold. All right, children. When shall we make the wedding?
Oh, thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Rectavia. You won't be sorry.
I won't be sorry. I'm already sorry. Children. What am I going to do about Skoda? What am I going to do about Skoda?
Ah! You were wonderful!
It was a miracle! It was a miracle!
Miracle.
No.